anatomy, the cornerstone of medical education. It's the foundation upon which all medical knowledge is built, guiding future physicians to understand the human body's complex structures and systems. In the journey to become a healthcare professional, mastering anatomy is not just a requirement, it's a necessity. It informs diagnoses, treatments, and surgical procedures, making it essential for saving lives and promoting health. However, the path to mastering anatomy is fraught with challenges. Traditional education methods often rely heavily on passive learning and rote memorization. These methods can hinder the development of critical thinking and the ability to visualize anatomical structures in three dimensions. This approach to learning anatomy has long needed a transformative change, one that moves beyond passive observation to active pedagogy, hands-on engagement, and experimental learning. Our study addresses this critical question by exploring the power of constructivist theories, which emphasize active learning through hands-on experiences. Our question is, how can we see what the student imagines? Our hypothesis is clay modeling. Students can reconstruct the geometrical shape that they can imagine, which can be considered as the geometrical mental representation of their understanding. To test this hypothesis, we designed a comparative study between three groups: blind, visually impaired, and control group. First phase, we start with a verbal description of an anatomical concept, prompting each participant to shape this concept into a clay model. This method bridges the gap between abstract verbal information and concrete geometric understanding. The reconstructed model represents the participant's mental representation of the concept. We then conduct a comparison analysis, evaluating each group's clay models against a standard structure to determine the accuracy and effectiveness of learning through touch. Second phase. During the post-touch phase, students engage in direct tactile interaction with reference anatomical models, blindfolded, to enhance their tactile perception. Afterwards, they again use clay modeling to reconstruct the structure. This time, our analysis focuses on a side-by-side comparison of these new clay models with the standard reference, determining the improvements in spatial understanding and memory retention facilitated by tactile experience. Turning our gaze to the results, we witness a remarkable advancement in the mental representation of anatomical structures. For individuals with visual impairments, average scores soar from 41.32 pre-touch to an astounding 85.65 post-touch. The blind group also sees significant gains, with scores rising from 67.28 to 83.41, and the control group scores leap from 47.81 to 87.10. When we delve into effect sizes, utilizing Cohen's D as our measure, the data speaks volumes. The blind group shows a considerable effect at 1.51. The control group follows closely, with an effect size of 1.6, on par with the overall impact. However, the visually impaired group stands out, with a profound effect size of 2.74, suggesting an extraordinary level of improvement. These numbers are not just statistics. They are a testament to the transformative power of tactile learning. Our study revealed that tactile intervention led to a notable increase in post-touch scores across all participant groups, demonstrating the limited efficacy of verbal descriptions alone. This tactile approach significantly enhanced spatial understanding, particularly for those with visual impairments. Blind participants showed a remarkable ability to comprehend complex concepts based on touch, reflecting their enhanced non-visual cognitive processing. The results firmly establish clay modeling not only as an effective educational tool, but also as a means to understand and appreciate the diverse ways in which individuals perceive and interact with the world around them.